If I start talking about the Bigfoot I met at the 7-Eleven, my friends, you know, will check in with me and they'll kind of like slow me down. Or if I start talking about the Illuminati, they'll say, whoa, whoa, Tim, you know, not today. And those social breaks are limiting to the speed and the sort of the directionality of my storytelling. But in the realm of social media, the breaks have come off. Hi, I'm Tim Tangherlini. I'm a professor in the Scandinavian Department and the School of Information here at UC Berkeley. I'm a folklorist by training, and I study storytelling at different scales, everything from the stories that your grandmother may have told you to the stories that you find on the internet. I've been challenged to explain the 101 of computational folklore in 101 seconds. Computational folklore is based on bringing together computational methods with the study of folklore. So this will be everything from fairy tales to legends to rumors to even conspiracy theories that you might be familiar with. By computational, I mean everything from gathering the data to making it machine actionable to using algorithms to find the underlying latent patterns that might give us clues as to how these expressive forms create meaning for the people who use them. In our everyday life, we're using storytelling to try and figure out this complex landscape in which we're living. Some of it is health generated, some of it is politically generated, some of it's economics. When we were in a pre-social media age, a lot of times our interactions were slowed down by the fact that they had to be face-to-face. But in the realm of social media, the breaks have come off. So you might think that you're communicating with people in your community. And what you might actually be doing is communicating with an army of bots. And this is something that computational folklorists can help with. We can figure out what the narrative frameworks are, and we can also see potentially where those are being manipulated by malign actors. So I've been interested in storytelling for a very long time. What is it that motivates people to tell stories, and how do those stories create meaning for us? In one of my research groups, we're looking at extracting character interaction networks from all of the Icelandic sagas, trying to get an understanding of, should you kill the berserker? It turns out that you probably should actually just go and kill the berserker. It has better outcomes downstream for you. You don't die necessarily. I found students are eager to embrace these projects. We all learn from each other, and I think that's something that is a hallmark of Berkeley.